The imagination of the public that Jim Henson captured and inspired is remarkable. I never had long conversations with Jim, but he just had a certain sensibility. Something about the way he looked at the world that you wanted to be a part of. You wanted him to take you with him wherever he was going.
Way before Sesame Street and his early appearances on the Ed Sullivan Show, you could see that this was very different approach to puppetry that he was coming up with. And, you know, and by the time he brought those creations to what Sesame Street had become, he had become probably, you know, without peer, you know, among puppet creators. You know, he had established his own, you know, vision and style of what puppetry was, and especially for television, because puppetry in its history, the history of puppetry, had very little to do with the medium of television. It had to do with, you know, the stage, you know, proscenium, you know, so marionettes, or there were hand puppets within a frame that, you know, but there was no need for the kinds of creations that Jim devised, which were really made for television. And then the variety of color and character and shape and form, and, you know, he could make anything into a puppet, you know.
You asked me about Muppets. That's not what impacted me. The first time I saw Jim Henson, it was like seeing Robin Hood and his Merry Men. Now, this was 69. Everything on Jim's body was buckskin, and it was lashed together with rawhide. I mean, his wife made his clothes, and his sandals were handmade, and he had this long brown hair and this benign, peaceful face. I said, who in the world is that? And then he had these crazy puppeteers with him. It's like Robin Hood and his Merry Men just came out of Sherwood Forest. I'd never seen any guys like that before in my life.
Jim was he never came off like a boss. And so in doing that, you know, you always wanted to give him over 100%. Because he respected you so much as being a part of it. He was the type that when Muppet Show was a success, everybody benefited from it.
Now, all my early upbringing in show business was comedians, Broadway. It certainly wasn't puppeteers. I said, Burr, you gotta be kidding. You're a puppeteer, but you're a genius. I have no time. He said, please, for me, just do me a favor, get him off my back. I said, okay. So my office was on the 26th floor at the time. And in walked, it's funny, it's like a through line of Jesus in this, because Jim Henson, bearded, skinny, came in carrying a box of, you know, like a carry box, and inside were all the puppets. But it wasn't all the ones that came on Sesame Street. It was the original group. And don't ask me why again. Instinct. He made me laugh.
I think one of my favorites with Jim was not a neighborhood piece. I was the animal guy also. I almost forgot about that. It's been so long. But whenever we had an animal in the show, I had to take care of that. And we had this giant American bullfrog that literally I could hold him like this. He was the biggest frog I've ever seen. So I was describing the life of a bullfrog. And Kermit came in, as Jim came in as Kermit, and he said, what are you doing? I said, well, I'm just talking about a giant American bullfrog. He said, well, I know a little something about that. And we went on this wonderful script, and he said they eat bugs, and he went, you know, just about got sick. And he said, I prefer French toast and pizza and myself, and went on, and I was holding this thing, and poor Jim is right underneath, and all of a sudden, I guess the frog got nervous on camera and did a frog thing, and Jim said, I thought, this just isn't fair for Jim Kermit to be having this happening to him. But he never stopped for a moment, went right on with the rest of the scene, but we had a good laugh over that one. But he was great. No matter, as I started to say, no matter how busy he was, he would stop and say, you know, what are you up to, and talking, and you always know that he had 80 things in his mind for where he came from, and he's got that many more where he was going, but he just always had plenty of time to sit and talk, and as though you were the most important person around, so.